Hey, what's going on, guys? My name's Chopper, and ladies and gentlemen, welcome to today's video. And in this one, we're going to be talking about the Hytale Beta, the full release of the game, the news surrounding all that, and a bunch of other really cool stuff that you guys are going to want to know before this game does release. Now, before we get into all of the info that we're going to discuss in this video, if you guys are excited for Hytale and want to see more stuff like this, be sure to leave a like rating on the video. And also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. This will be your one-stop shop for everything Hytale. So that being said, sit back, relax, enjoy the video, and let's get started. To begin here, I want to show off a little bit what Hytale is currently doing and show you the work and the progress that they've made very recently. So a brand new biome is looking to be finished up right now. This is what they're calling Zone 3, and it's essentially like what you can think of a snowy sort of part of the map, where it has like deep caves that kind of go around. It has snowy ice tunnels, and they spider around a really cold and dense bleak forest. Now what's so cool about this is that there's going to be unique enemies that are specifically in each part of this biome. For example, you can find a sort of snow yeti monster when you go into the ice caves, but if you travel a little bit deeper into the tunnels, you're going to find most likely that you're stuck in a dungeon encounter with a skeletal defender, which sounds absolutely insane. And not only that, but a tribe called the Outlanders are going to have their own bases set up and their own structures and forts that are meant to keep people out of there. But you know, if you play your cards right, at the same time, this can be a safe haven to, you know, protect you and have a shelter from the bitter cold that is the rest of the biome. This is a good representation of what this area is supposed to look and feel like, right? You have this sort of like barren wasteland in a way, and the Outlanders, which is the tribe obviously who inhabited it, kind of made it their home. So with this biome, something that's fascinating, and it goes for all of the other zones that they have in the game as well, all of them are associated with a certain element, and it seems that this one is associated closely with the element of corruption. The corruption seems to be most heavy around the campsites where it's likely being practiced, so that's something to look out for in the biome, and especially like when you look around the rest of it, such as the ice caves and mountains, you don't really see too much of that. However, it is represented, I guess, as a whole in that biome itself. It's a very cool part to be looking out for, and I'm excited to play in it. And there's another area that you can play in that is way more packed and filled with life. Right now, this is just called Zone 1, but you can think about it as pretty much the polar opposite of the last area that we just talked about. This seems to be way more vibrant, way more living and breathing, and just full of biodiversity and life. There's an unbelievably large amount of animals that inhabit this zone, you know, such as ducks, deer, frogs, pigeons, and so many more. Everything ranging from completely friendly to absolutely hostile. Now, when it comes to things that you can do in these parts of the biomes and things that will be available to you, for example, there are going to be already set up dungeons that are prefabricated from the beginning when you load up into the map. And what you can do is explore these dungeons and go deeper and deeper with a challenge in each room. And then the final master room, whatever you'd like to call it, is going to present the greatest challenge. But if you're able to complete that, you're going to get the biggest reward. And here's a really nice top-down view of what these dungeons are going to look like. And as you can see at the bottom, is going to be the toughest room, but going to give you the biggest reward. And these dungeons and caves don't just exist above ground either. These are things that you can find underwater as well, or different caves that are leading into the depths of the ocean where you can do this exact same sort of thing, which is very exciting. So that's a really nice overview of what they've been working on recently and how close they are to completing all of that. Now, moving on to the beta and the release date of this, which I'm sure most of you guys are wondering about, when the Hytale beta is going to be released, when you can actually get your hands on the game, and what platforms are going to be available to play Hytale onto. The official Hytale trailer came out in December of 2018, and from what we saw in there, it looked to be pretty much done, you know what I mean? Like, all the features seemed to be pretty intact, and it was running very well, and they felt confident enough to show it off. However, we've not heard anything just yet. Now, they have made an official statement on when their beta is going to be released, so I'll go ahead and show you that right now. So this is on the release of the Hytale beta when asked about it. The date is still to be confirmed. We're eager to get it into the hands of players, but we want to make sure we do it at a time that makes sense. We want to be confident that we deliver a first impression worthy of player expectations, as well as our own ambitions. Rest assured that we are ramping up production to deliver the game to you as fast as we're able to, while also meeting these standards. So let's go ahead and break down what all of that means and what we can decipher from when the beta is going to come out based on this, and then also the full game subsequently after that. So what they say in the first part is pretty fascinating. They said, we're eager to get it into the hands of players, but we want to make sure we do so at a time that makes sense. Now, what does that even mean? I think it means two things. First of all, I think that Hypixel is aiming to release Hytale as a summer release, as the full game. The beta itself aside, we'll get to that in a moment, but I think that they want to make the full game available during the summer. This would make sense, as they wouldn't have much competition in the ways of other games that are coming out around that time. You know, big games that are going to be coming out this year normally happen more around the fall time of the year, so if they were to release in summer, it'd be virtually without competition. I think it would be a smart move. And then that kind of leads us into the beta. Originally, from what I was told and the info that was going around, the Hytale beta was supposed to be released sometime sometime in late March, and obviously it is April at the time of me recording this video, and it hasn't happened yet, so what's the deal? Apparently that was the original plan, to have the beta in March, but evidently there was a little bit of delay over at the studio when developing this game, and that's not even something that I would take as a negative. That's not even unhealthy for a game. In fact, I think it's a good thing, because you don't want them to either be testing the game and not all the bugs have been worked out yet, and it just comes out as a half-baked product with not as much content as maybe was promised, and then that would turn a lot of people off to the game. That's happened to so many in the past, and I would just hate to see it for this, so I'm glad that they're at least maybe stepping back for at least for a little bit to take their time and make sure that they deliver on the promises that they made in the trailers and all the content. But the takeaway from the beta that I can make out of all this information, if it's not going to be in March, because obviously we're past that now, I think it has to be maybe late May. If they're going to go for a summer release, this would be the prime time to do it. And assuming things are moving along as they have been recently and as smoothly as they say they have, then as far as just the beta itself, I think it's going to be maybe mid to late May. And all the evidence that I've seen so far definitely points towards that. So that's what I would be looking out for. Now, the full game itself is a different story. Whenever we get the beta, you can rest assured that the full game is coming shortly after, because these days, betas are not necessarily beta tests where we wait a long period before the full release of the game comes out. It hasn't been that way, and I'd say the last 5 years. So what I would say, if Hytale is going to follow a similar pattern that all other modern video games have been following, then the beta is going to come out maybe, like I said, late May probably, and then the full game is going to release very shortly after, because the beta is essentially just a demo for the full game. Now, that's assuming, of course, that everything is going smoothly and working properly over on their end at Hytale, so that is a little bit dependent on them too, but I wouldn't say it can't be any later than maybe late summer, but I would probably tell you that a June release, maybe mid to late June, is probably when we're going to see the full release of the game, and of course, we're going to have the beta before that. I think it's coming up sooner than you might expect. Now, what's cool is that the CEO of Hypixel itself tweeted about the release date of this game, and he says this: the only true release for Hytale is when it's ready. The real pressure we have come from our amazing community and ourselves to make a great game. We have funding and support to achieve our vision. We just need to keep working hard. Thank you for your patience. So this is kind of reflects exactly what I said earlier, is that it's going to be soon, but it's something that we still got to wait on, at least for them to finish up on their end. So to quickly sum up all that information we just said, I know that was kind of a lot, but all the points you need to take home is I'm predicting the beta right now to probably be in late May, and then the full game either in mid-June or late June, somewhere around a summer release, based on everything we know right now. Now, moving on here, I want to talk about what platforms it's going to be available on and how much the game is going to cost, because this is a pretty important topic as well, as many of you guys are going to want to know how much money you should save for this thing or what kind of console or platform you need to play it. Let's tackle the price thing first, because I think this is the only way to really have them consider this point of view, right? They haven't worked out the model specifically what they want to have for Hytale yet, but I think a free-to-play with microtransactions in it would be the best way to go. Get as many people as you physically can able to play the game, and then you can spend optional money after if you would like. I think we're finally going to get some solid information on that soon, but I would tell you that it's either going to be like a free-to-play model with microtransactions in it, similar to what a Fortnite does these days, or it's going to follow the Minecraft model where you do purchase the game from the beginning, and then you can also buy like little stuff inside the game as well. Either way, I think is going to work, but I think the preferred model would be the free-to-play. You guys can let me know what you think about that in the comment section. Which pricing model you'd tend to prefer? I'd say most people would like the free-to-play model, and I think that's the way to go as far as like the video game culture these days. Now, when it comes to platforms that you're able to play Hytale on, this is another kind of hot-button issue, as I'm not so sure that everybody is going to be able to play the game as soon as it comes out. Currently, Hytale only has a planned release as soon as the game comes out for PC and Mac. So this means if you're playing on console, or even if you're a mobile player, these things are not going to be available to you day one whenever the game does end up coming out. But rest assured, I think it's going to pull a Minecraft where they are going to look into developing it for other platforms. And if the game is a major success, then they pretty much have no other choice but to do that. So to answer that question, day one is only going to be a PC and Mac feature and available game. But I would say later down the road, it's definitely going to be available for console and potentially even available for a mobile release as well sometime down the road. But ladies and gentlemen, that is going to wrap up the video for today. I hope I was able to answer some of your questions about the release of this game with the very limited info that we do have on it. I've done my own digging. I've done as much research as I could to bring you guys a solid prediction on everything that's going to be happening with this game. So let me know your feedback in the comment section down below if you're excited for Hytale, and let me know what you're excited most about. If you guys haven't already signed up for the Hytale beta, there will be a link inside the description where you can go sign up for free right now. You just give them an email and then they'll give you a code or something to download when it does come out. So if you're not already signed up for the beta, make sure you go ahead and do that. Like I said, links in the description. And of course, drop a like on the video if you guys enjoyed, and subscribe if you are brand new around here for more Hytale content. There's going to be daily Hytale videos as soon as the game does release. And like I said, this will be your one place for everything of the game. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you go follow me on Twitter and on Instagram. That is linked inside the description. Hope you guys have a fantastic rest of your day, and I'll see you all on the next stream or the next video. Take it easy, guys, and peace out.